Hiker Jay here. This week I'm going to be talking about the long-handled spoon spork for backpacking that so many people have gone to, why they've gone to it, and which one I like better. There's different brands and such, but in the past people have used just like a regular light my fire type of a plastic ABS type spoon spork. This used to be my favorite one, but people have really gone to these long-handled spoon forks because of dehydrated food. It's just easier to get in there and keeps your hand from getting messed up. So I'm going to talk about the one from Tokes and Sea to Summit, compare them and tell you which one I like best. All right, time to set the table. My spoon fork, and I don't know, how does it go? Does it go spoon, fork? There are sporks, there are everything. So I haven't taken an etiquette class in quite a while. So, what's up? Well, all right, it's dog approved too. I also, hey, if this is the first time to my channel, if you would, please hit subscribe and like, that would be awesome. I put out videos every week regarding to outdoor gear, and I really appreciate it. All right, before I begin this review, I brought you in close. I want to talk about this zip sack. This is my kitchen. It's an Outdoor Research zip sack, and it works awesome. I actually did a whole review on what I carry in there and how it works in my kitchen, and you can click the link up on the right here and check that out. So let's talk about the past. The past, I used to carry a Light My Fire spork-style spoon, fork, knife style thing, and I loved it. But when it came to eating dehydrated meals, which I've gone to a lot, it just doesn't work. If you have a single meal like this, single serving, you can see that here's the seam. It just gets down there. What happens is you put your fingers in there and you get everything all over you. Certainly a two-person style, which is what I eat normally by myself, you get in there and you're gonna get all sloppy. So what people have gone to are these long-handled sporks. And there's a couple versions out there. This is the Sea to Summit, which is an aluminum, and this is the titanium torque style. And you can just see how much further you can get in to one of these bags, especially single serving, and get food out and not get all nasty and dirty. On top of it, not only is it great with these types of dehydrated meals, but this style, this format with the actual curve to it with the bowl, you could pick up an awesome amount of rice or food or even ramen noodles with the actual fork ends of it. Works really, really nicely. So these two are nearly identical. You'll find the Sea to Summits on Amazon. I got the link down below, and it's probably their best seller, and it's great. I mean, when you look at them, their forks, they're cut in the same way, and I mean, they have the hook back here. The difference is the Sea to Summit comes with like a carabiner. The titanium one, the Torx, comes with this nice little case so you can keep it clean, but it does add a little bit of weight. When it comes down to it, it's the durability. The Sea to Summit is 0.4 ounces and it's made out of aluminum. The Torx is made out of titanium and it is 0.6 ounces. And you can kind of see, I mean, the aluminum is pretty flexible, easy to kind of get some flex to it. The titanium, I really got to get after to get some flex. So I guess if you're really hard on your gear, I would go for the titanium. They both have the powder coated handle, and this is where the Torx starts to go off and be my favorite one at when we get down to the actual spoon spork end of it. Sea to Summit has put the powder coating on their entire bowl, and I don't really like it. I don't like the texture of my mouth. I just don't like it. I like how it's got the smooth polished bowl on the titanium one. Additionally, these fork spots right here, and it's probably because the powder coating is resistance, you know, it's like adds friction, and they're just not as pokey, and like these are kind of like, when you touch the edges, they're sharp. And at first I worried about that until I ate with it and had no problem. I didn't cut my mouth or anything like that. But where it really comes into play is, say you're eating one of these meals and you just want to stab like a piece of pineapple that's in there or something. You have to use a lot more force with this one to poke something because of it's not as sharp and it has all that resistance. And I'll kind of show you, like, here's the apples. Okay. So like if I go to just poke an apple with the Sea to Summit, it took quite a bit of force to actually push it in and to make it go. And that's because it's powder coated and it's not as sharp. The titanium, the Torx one, it goes in really easily and comes out kind of nicely. So what's the plus to that? The plus is when you are trying to get something from the bottom of a bag or whatever, you're like less likely to actually poke the bottom of the bag and have, you know, your the water and things actually come out. So ultimately, I think that the Torx, titanium has an upper edge, even though it's a little bit heavier. But if you're really worried about weight, I would go with the Sea-Doo Summit. But they're both really great options. This is my son's, and he really loves it. He is kind of jealous of the shiny bowl because it just feels better in your mouth when it feels like a normal spoon. But either one is an excellent option for backcountry utensils. And this is all you need once you get this set up, because you can also, I know it doesn't have a knife, but you can see how easily these cut into like an apple or something. You can even see how this aluminum kind of flexes when you do it too, which is interesting, where the titanium doesn't even give me any flex when I'm cutting into one of these. Just a stiffer, stronger, yum. Stiffer, stronger spoon. Of course, you get that 0.2 ounces more with this one. Interestingly, these right here are 0.3 ounces, so they were lighter, but I'm kind of almost doubling with what I'm doing here. The option to carry this is kind of nice too, because once you clean your spoon and it's nice and clean, you can put it in here and I can throw it into my Zipsack kitchen here, and it won't get all messed up with the stove and everything in there. Even the dog likes it. So I know that it's just a spoon fork for the wilderness, and that might not seem like that big of a deal, but it really is. I would say grab one of these. They're pretty affordable. I have the link down below to my Amazon affiliate, and try it out. Once you try it, you will love it. Even like the dog. Grab it. There you go. All right. So till next time, just remember, life's a hike, so hike happy. With a long-handled spork. Some more. Go. Get that one out the back.